Hello friends, welcome to Insight Techs. This is the platform to learn about power transmission elements and control systems. In previous videos, we have learned about the requirement of transmission and power system and also the importance of transmitting power at high voltages and how it is beneficial to the power system. In today's video, we are going to learn about the various components of the power transmission. As it can be seen that at the generation end, there is one substation and also at the load end, there is another substation. The generating end substation and the load end substation are connected through various transmission lines. Let us understand how this power is transmitted through this power transmission lines. So basically, power can be transmitted in two different ways. First is through AC transmission and second is the DC transmission. In this video, we are going to learn about AC transmission. The various elements of AC transmission are substation and transmission lines. So let us understand about various types of substation. So broadly, the substations can be categorized based on the situation of the substation, that is where they are located and what type of insulating medium they are using. The first one is indoor substation, where the equipments like transformer are located inside a closed room, hence the name is indoor substation. Next is the outdoor substation, where all the equipments of the substation are located into the open space, so they are called as outdoor substation. Next is the air insulated substation, AIS, where air is used as an insulating medium by all the equipments. Next is the gas insulated substation, that is a GIS, where SF6 gas is normally used as an insulating medium to transmit power. Other category is the hybrid type of substation, where few equipments are air insulated and other equipments are gas insulated. This kind of substations are normally used in the congested area where the requirement of space to make a substation is less. Then the substations can be classified as step-up substation or step-down substation based on the different voltage levels. Step-up substations are generally the substations near a generating station where the voltage levels are transformed from generating voltage levels to transmitting voltage levels. 6.6 kV to 132 kV, 11 to 132 kV and 11 to 220. Next are step-down substation. This kind of substations are situated at the load end. Here the voltage is stepped down from high voltage levels to the load voltage levels. That is 33 kV to 11 kV, 66 kV to 11 kV, 132 kV to 33 or 11 kV, and also this kind of substations are situated in between the transmission lines to change the voltage levels from 765 to 400 or 1200 to 765 kV. At present, 1200 to 765 kV voltage level step down substations are being made in India. Next component of AC transmission is the transmission line. There are different types of transmission line which can be categorized based on different tower designs, based on different voltage levels, based on type of insulators and based on type of conductors. So based on different tower designs, the transmission line can be classified as single pole line, H-frame line or a tower line. Normally single pole lines are used for low voltage levels. For 11 kV lines, H-frames are used for medium voltage levels, that is up to 66 kV lines, and tower lines are based on the voltage levels above 66 and 132 kV lines. Again, based on different voltage levels, that is 33, 66 and 132 above, that is low, medium and high voltage levels. Based on different insulators, that is overhead lines and underground lines. Overhead lines are air insulated. Then, based on different types of conductors, that is overhead conductors, again they are air insulated. The type of conductors are basically decided based on the ampere carrying capacity of the line, that is panther conductor, moose conductor, dog conductor. These are different types of conductors normally used in India at present. Then there are power cable lines that are again underground lines, and these are the type of underground lines are used in the city area where installing transmitting towers will require more space and it becomes congested in the city area. Hence, power cable lines are normally used. In the next video, we will learn about various elements of the substation. Thank you.